Do you know in which countries common hamsters live? Let me show it to you. This is me, David. I'm a professional filmmaker and wildlife explorer from Germany. In the past years, I worked on the biggest film about the common hamster worldwide. In this video, I want to show you the distribution range of the common hamster and how badly this species shrunk in the past years. And did you also know that there are different genetic lineages of the common hamster? This will be shown to you in the second half of the video. So let's start. Common hamsters prefer continental climates and have special requirements in terms of soil conditions. They require sufficient loam and loess deposits. Black loess soils are very suitable for hamsters to build deep and permanent burrows. For winter burrows, the common hamster prefers loams that are easy to dig because they are less prone to collapse. Earthworms, step marmots, and hamsters themselves play an important role in the formation of black earth. In its greatest expansion in the middle of the 20th century, the common hamster once occurred from Belgium and France in the west to its eastern distribution limit in Russia and China. Here it colonizes a large belt of plains and hilly landscapes with suitable soils and climate. I have compiled the most up-to-date distribution map of the common hamster from all publicly available data. This shows that populations have collapsed to a minimum. In Europe, for example, the number of individuals has fallen by more than 75%. As a result, the common hamster is now categorized as endangered not only in individual countries, but worldwide. In order to better plan conservation measures, scientists, for example here in Poland, are analyzing the genetic diversity of the common hamster. To this end, they are installing hair traps fitted with adhesive tape in the entrances to the burrows to collect genetic samples from the hamsters. Now they have to wait and see whether a hamster leaves its hairs on one of the rolls. This hamster seems unamazed about the roll in its burrow entrance. But once it has made it outside, the roll is quickly removed again. If other animals also leave their hair on the roll, this could contaminate the samples. After some time, the hair traps are checked. They are carefully removed from the hamster tubes and examined. The common hamster has left many hairs on this trap, which are collected with tweezers and preserved for later analysis. Using a similar procedure, scientists have discovered that there are 5 genetic lines of the common hamster worldwide. After the last ice age, the different lineages of the common hamster emerged as a result of dispersal movements. In Poland, 3 of these lineages are theoretically contagious. Today, however, they are highly isolated not only from other countries but also within Poland. The differences between the individual genetic lineages are the subject of current research. Research into the different genetic lines is not only interesting in order to understand the worldwide dispersal movement, it is also interesting for breeding. Differentiation takes place below the species level. All common hamsters can theoretically mate with each other. Nevertheless, the lines are relevant for breeding in order to find suitable donor populations. In Poland, as in Hungary, I can film hamsters of the P line. Compared to the E line, these are somewhat smaller and have longer feet and tails, which is why I affectionately call them hobbit hamsters. Especially in the evening hours here in Poland, I can observe the curious hamsters on their forays. And that's it for today. I hope you liked the video and you learned something new. I would really appreciate your free subscription, and then we'll see each other in the next video. Bye bye.